Hello everyone, it's Dr. Jen. I hope everyone's doing well during this pandemic. I was talking with my partner Mark last night, and you know, we've been watching a lot about the pandemic, like most people. Not too much, but enough. And I thought I would do this quick video today on sort of the education of a nation. There's been so many of us out there who work in emergency management and public safety, and during the last pandemic that we had that passed around, we worked on pandemic planning. I know I worked with the Red Cross and pandemic planning at that time. And who would have ever thought this would happen? But we knew it could happen. And a lot of people who don't work in the field didn't necessarily take the threat seriously, because, you know, why would they? It doesn't happen every day. Understandable. But here we are, and it's happening. And so I thought I would just share a few words on, you know, how the nation's being educated and how interesting it is, you know, in general at this time. But also to just remind everybody who is in charge of what during an outbreak or a pandemic. There's a great graphic that I'll share a link to below that kind of explains this. I'm going to look at my notes while I talk about this with you a little bit, to just share, you know, what I know and what you may not remember or what hasn't been clear in watching things on TV, etc. So who is in charge of what during an outbreak or a pandemic? There's some categories of agencies that we look to during a pandemic. As you may have heard or not, our president, President Trump, has very publicly withdrawn financial support from the World Health Organization, WHO. So that's happened in recent weeks. And since that's happened, you know, it's more important than ever for us to know who else is in charge in the United States. And so again, I'll put the link for this graphic where I'm getting a lot of this information below, but it's information I know from, you know, working in the field for quite a while. This graphic just really breaks it down, which is wonderful. So it shows us, you know, sort of who does what during a pandemic. So the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, which is often referred to in its acronym form as DHHS, they notify the WHO, which again, we're not really working with very much here in the United States, on any incident that impacts the world like this one. They lead the protection of the health of our civilian population against both the international and accidental or naturally occurring threats. Right now, we're really not sure how this originated in Wuhan, China. We know, we believe that it originated there. We don't know how. It could have been at a lab. It's pretty much been determined that it wasn't at the wet market, but it could have been an animal. We don't know. Anyhow, the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, again, DHHS, as it's often called, coordinates with three different agencies under their purview, which is the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, you often hear CDC, the Assistant Secretary for Preparedness and Response, and the Food and Drug Administration, so the FDA. So the CDC, it's the United States Public Health Authority, and they direct the nation's scientific response, the mitigation and prevention of any kind of an outbreak. So that's what the CDC does. They provide technical assistance, disseminate key public information, and rapid and sustained public health assessment. So that's what they do. Whereas the Assistant Secretary for Preparedness and Response, they help lead the federal public health and medical response to emergencies, requests, and provide assistance to the locally led efforts. So that's what they do. And they look at the restoration piece, healthcare, social service networks of the affected individuals and communities. So that's where their focus is. And the third under DHHS is the Food and Drug Administration, the FDA. And the FDA's Medical Countermeasures Initiative, led by the Office of Counterterrorism and Emerging Threats, they provide strategic leadership and coordination for FDA's counterterrorism and emerging threat portfolio. What does that mean? So basically, any complex scientific and regulatory challenges facing medical countermeasures, development, availability, and security, that's what they focus on. So it's a little complicated, but that's basically what those three pieces do under DHHS. And then we also have, of course, the U.S. Department of Homeland Security, and they have three pieces as well. So what does the U.S. Department of Homeland Security do? DHS, as it's often referred to, what do they do during this type of an incident? Well, they are the principal federal official for domestic incident management. So the secretary is responsible for coordinating federal operations within the United States to prepare for, respond to, and recover from terrorist attacks, major disasters, and other emergencies like this. DHS serves as information conduit across multiple agencies and to the National Security Council for operational control and coordination. So situational awareness and decision support through the National Biosurveillance Integration Center information system, public information and warning messaging happens through the United States Department of Homeland Security, so DHS. And under their purview, you'll know that, of course, FEMA, the Federal Emergency Management Agency, the United States Coast Guard, the United States Customs and Border Protection, and finally the Cyber Security and Infrastructure Security Agency, those agencies work under DHS to ensure that what I just talked about is happening. So I'm not going to go into the details of all of those folks. I will add, though, that the United States Department of Defense works specifically with the Defense Intelligence Agency and National Center for Medical Intelligence and the Armed Forces Health Surveillance Branch. And then finally, the U.S. Department of Justice works with the FBI, the Federal Bureau of Investigation. And they're responsible for the law enforcement side of things. So again, looking at this graphic, it's a lot clearer than, you know, me just talking to you in a camera. But I said all of this in less than 5 minutes. If you take out the beginning part where I just said hello. and so, you know, you can read it, you can digest it and understand it. You know, if you're not somebody who's in the field dealing with this all the time. And, you know, it's amazing to see how people are becoming educated. Hopefully this, you know, worldwide type of pandemic, we won't see something this big in our lifetime. Maybe never again, hopefully. Let's all hope. But because it can happen and has happened, you know, the probability is there. And so the best thing we can do is to be educated. And like a lot of my colleagues are saying, you know, mitigate in advance and, you know, and do what we can to help our families, our neighbors, our coworkers, and ourselves, you know, as we work through it. So if you have any additional information to share about how the nation's preparing or how we coordinate, please don't hesitate to add it below in the comments. Just wanted to share this information with you. And I wish everyone the best. I hope you're doing well. All right, take care. Have a good week.